Hey guys, how's it going? This is David Kwan here. So apparently I make money as a writer. Yeah, and I'm saying apparently not to be ironic or to be comical or anything, but I genuinely mean it. Like, apparently. Like, I'm surprised by this. Like, what? Seriously? I really do make money as a writer? Not much money, mind you. Like, the amount of money that I get from having wrote some articles on this Yahoo content, Yahoo Voices, years ago. The amount of money I'm making every month is, like, so tiny. Maybe I can buy a cup of coffee with it, you know? It's that little, you know? And the total amount of money I receive from Yahoo will probably be able to make... I could probably buy a video game with it, you know? And maybe have a little more change after that. But that's about the extent. I don't think I can really specify... I'm not allowed to really specify how much money... bit has been given to me for having written some articles. But the thing is, this is a weird thing, you know? I haven't written an article or published an article in my Yahoo account for close to a year or more. I think I've been on a very long hiatus. And yet, the last time they paid me was this month. So I'm still getting paid for something I wrote years ago, which is, I think that's just a crazy thing, you know? It's not like most jobs that people have. It's like an hourly thing, you know, they work, and then it's because they work, the money that they get is, you know, is immediate, you know, 2 weeks from now, or a month from now, the money that they get is directly related to the work that they did that month, or that, the previous week. But this is something that I did, like, a year ago, or 2 years ago. Now, I'm still being paid for it. That's, like, the craziest thing for me. Like, I'm not putting in any effort right now, and I'm getting a notice in my email saying, You just got this much in your PayPal. Like, what? There's that huge disconnect there. And I think it makes me wonder, like, you know, people who make money off of making YouTube videos, people who write a novel or a short story and they publish it and it becomes a bestseller, like, it must be that kind of an effect kind of thing. You know, you put, like, to their credit, you know, they put so much work. A lot of those people who get insane amount of views on YouTube, you know, they make so much effort into their videos, they have... The stuff they come up with is very creative. So to their credit, you know, it's some of the content that gets put out there on YouTube is amazing. You know, the books and stuff that we pay money for and purchase, you know, it's amazing. But the concept is you have this idea in your head and then you put it on YouTube or you put it on paper and then you share it to the rest of the world. And years later, it's still giving you income or generating money for you. I think that's such an amazing, powerful, captivating concept that, like, anyone with an internet access can potentially make money. And that money will keep coming in throughout your life. Now, as time goes by, the amount of money will dwindle and dwindle. So you'll still need to create content. But people who produce content like that usually produce content because not only because of the money, but because they enjoy doing that. And that's kind of why I did YouTube... I'm doing YouTube. I'm not doing it to make money. I've never made a single cent from my YouTube videos, mostly because I don't monetize my videos. I don't think they deserve monetization because of the little effort I put into it. And also because I don't really get many views on my videos, which I'm fine with, you know. I'm surprised at all that people would actually watch some of my videos and really comment on them and have discussions with them. So I really appreciate you guys. Watching my videos and commenting on them and stuff like that. That's really cool that I'm part of this community where I can make videos and watch other people's videos and be part of this community. That's awesome. And so I wrote the articles on Yahoo, just be like, hey, here's some stuff I wrote in college. Maybe I'll just publish them. Here's a short story I wrote before. Here's my poem collection. Boom. You know, that was kind of it. And then all of a sudden I'm like wondering, like, wow, people are actually clicking on it and clicking ads on it. And that's generating income for me. Albeit tiny bit, but the fact that I'm making money off of something I wrote years ago is an amazing, powerful concept. I still can't wrap my mind around that. You know, it motivates me a little bit. It makes me think why I haven't written anything for Yahoo. You know, maybe I should start writing more and see where that happens. I think writing is one of those things where I'm actually pretty decent at. I wouldn't say I'm a great writer or anything, but like I think I'm okay at it. So I'll see where it leads me, you know, maybe next time. And the surprising thing is I haven't even done any marketing for my articles on Yahoo. You know, it's not like I publish something on Yahoo and I'm just like, hey, I go on Twitter, it's like, this is what I wrote. You know, I do that for YouTube. You know, every time I make a YouTube video, like, I tweet, you know. And it's not on Facebook, but anyway, that wouldn't make a difference. And it's going to be on my Google Plus account, so there's a little bit of marketing for my YouTube videos. But for Yahoo, nothing. It's just out there. Some large amounts of people are stumbling onto my articles and reading them and clicking on the ads. And somehow, something I wrote years ago is still paying me. It's amazing. I make money as a writer, apparently. I don't know. I think that's such a crazy thing. But yeah, that's what I wanted to kind of talk about today. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Yeah, cheers.